People are trying to evolve. Let them evolve.
Yes.
Let them evolve. Don't bring them back into the, don't bring them back where they came from. It's a painful truth. We all have different things in our life that have scarred us. We want to act like those scars don't exist. So those scars, like, you know, if you go out and you get cut, that scar is going to be there on your arm. You can go down and look at that cut and say, oh, or that scar and say, oh, that happened from, you know, I was in the kitchen or what happened. We have the same thing on our brain. You have to start with yourself. So what happened in my life was we start to get, I call it like the rucksack. A rucksack is a pack that you carry in the military and you put all your stuff in it. Your radios, your food, your water, all that stuff you have to carry in the military. That's your rucksack. It's a backpack pretty much. As you're growing up, we all have a backpack. Most of ours hopefully is empty, you know, and what we put in it is all the crap we go through in life. That's what is in the backpack for the civilians, and we carry it around with us. So what you have to start doing is realizing that no matter where you're at in life, I got called nigger a lot. My dad abused me, you know, learning disabilities, stutters, immaturity, insecurities, self-doubt, so much crap on top of me. So much stuff. I lied a lot to create friends. So much stuff was in my backpack. No one's coming back to help me. So it starts with that person in that mirror. You have to realize you are on your own now. And whatever else you believe in, I don't care what you believe in, but on earth, it's a very lonely journey. And it starts with the accountability mirror of looking at saying, hey, my daddy beat the hell out of me, he's not coming back. All these things are coming back. I have to face myself. And you have to own all those things that people may have done to you. Now it's yours. You got to own it. It's yours now to fix the problems that people did to you. It makes no sense. It's not fair. I get it. But if you live in that woe is me mentality of guess what? My dad did this to me. My mom just did it to me. People who bully did this to me. You're going to always live right there. You have to figure out ways to move forward because you're not coming back. It starts with the mirror. I call it the accountability mirror in the book. You don't want to break open that callous, that scar on your mind. You don't want to break, you know, you have to break it open, let that blood flow. You have to let blood flow in your brain. You have to let all that stuff flow out. All that toxic stuff that you have trapped in there has to start flowing out now. So, like you said, you are doing this to yourself. Yes, people may have helped you get there, but it's now on you. Painful truth, like all those people in high school and everything else, they don't know how you're gonna end up. So you gotta make sure that you constantly are rewriting your book. You have to constantly rewrite your book every day of your life. You know, and that these aren't just words I say, this is how I have to live. Like, these are conversations I have with myself. And I say it everywhere I go, the most important conversation when you have with yourself.
Yes.
You live with it every single day. But most of our conversations are not the right ones. They're not the ones that are gonna push us to the place we need to go. They're the ones that are gonna keep us sitting in that toxic environment that you've helped create and everybody else helped create, and you just live in it. You live in that muck, and that conversation just plays in your head. That becomes you. So my first conversation when I was absolutely nobody, and that's one thing you have to say. We live in a world now that's so kind. We find the kind way around everything. Like, if you don't look good, I have to find a kind way of saying, I don't like your shirt.
Right.
That's not the approach. If that's the approach you're looking for, that book is not for you. Can't hurt me is not for you. The approach you have to take, at least I took, you take whatever approach you want. The conversation had to be a real honest conversation in the accountability mirror of, guess what? I was fat. Don't find a kind word to say that, you know what? I've gained some weight. No, you're fat. When I couldn't read, not like, hey, you know, you have a learning disability. No, I cannot read. I have a fourth grade reading level, I'm struggling. And sometimes I call myself stupid. Not in a way to put myself down. So don't take it like, my God, those are so hurtful. Yeah, they're hurtful, it's honest. The conversation has to become an honest conversation of where you're at mentally. Where am I at mentally? I look like shit. I feel like shit. I'm falling behind in school. I'm lazy. My house is a mess. You have to look at what it is and call it what it is. Don't find words to make yourself feel better, because that's what, so we hang around people that make us feel better. that tell us what we want to hear, not what we need to hear. And so we stay away from those people. And we stay away from those people, like our internal dialogue becomes that kind, it's okay, it's not okay. So that's where it starts. It starts with that accountability of, it's not okay anymore. This can no longer be okay. And calling yourself out for exactly what you are and exactly how you need to fix it. That's where it starts. We are skirting all these conversations because if I say this, I'm gonna offend a black person or a white person or a Jewish person or a gay or lesbian person. We skirt around the daggone problem. So we can't fix shit. Everything is like, well, if I say this on TV, I'm gonna lose my damn job. We have to say it. We have to break the barriers within our minds, within the world. And it starts with yourself. Mm. It starts with yourself. You gotta break the barriers down within yourself and just go there. You gotta go to yourself. Do not forget your roots. Do not forget your roots. Don't let this become so big that you lose yourself amongst the noise. Go back to the quietness of what made you successful. That's the conversation now. It's a constant reminder of that. There's something inside you. The brain is the most powerful thing. The mind is the most powerful thing that we have. It's not your phone. It's not the computer. It's not anything. It's your mind. And if you can tap into that, you can come from the daggone roots of hell and become such a great seed, a powerful seed that can grow into some great daggone garden. And people don't get that. It's all up here. The power and the magic's up here. There's so much stuff going on right now in the world. People are trying to evolve. Let them evolve.
Yes.
Let them evolve. Don't bring them back into the, don't bring them back where they came from.
Yes.
Don't bring, if someone wants to get better, don't bring them back to where you knew them when they were a piece of shit. Mm-hmm. Let them fly. And if you feel like hell because they went away and they escaped the hell that you all once lived in, fix yourself. Fix yourself. Don't hold them accountable because they got away. Don't constantly remind them that they were once here. Fix yourself. Because a lot of people feel like crap once people start to leave their little nest, like if you're an alcoholic and this guy says, I'm gonna stop drinking. You wanna bring him right back in. No, look at yourself in the mirror and say, wow, this guy's doing better. Take that feeling of feeling like shit and do something about it. Change your own life. That's 100%, it makes us feel like shit. It's a constant reminder of where we're at in life. When you see people start to, even this one person, let's say you have a group of 10 friends, best friends, you guys party, smoke weed, drink, you guys are just 9-to-5ers, making minimum wage, we're just getting by. Like Goodwill Hunting. Mm-hmm. You watch that movie?
Yeah, absolutely, love it.
That guy wanted to stay there. Matt Damon wanted to stay there, you know? Ben Affleck was like, no, man, get the fuck out of here, man. That's the kind of people you want to be around. And those people, there's very few people like that exist in those crowds because you are a constant reminder of who they are now. This guy got out. Now, every day I wake up thinking, God, I'm a piece of shit. I'm a piece of shit. But I don't have the courage and the strength and the self-discipline to do what he did. So it's a constant reminder. I don't have the courage, but you do. You do have the courage. You just got to find it.